perspective. Ibrahim Nazuru Mantu and the Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu campaign for candidature for the president under the NRC was headed by late Senator Haruna Abubakar of blessed memory, and so many others I cannot even mention. I remember when he was coming here, we went up to Sabongida, which is close to 16 kilometers to Lafia. That was the boundary where we received him, and it was a fantastic reception. And he, as you know him, you probably know him better than me, he's always a crowd puller everywhere he goes. And that aspect of his life was also translated when he came to Lafia here. He pulled a large crowd. And as you may have heard from the chief of Adudu, it was a tremendous experience that we all had, because he was also there and has always been part of what is happening. But we know, we related to him on one-on-one, and we found him a very, very interesting person. Chief Iwuanyanwu, when we walked with him, the most singular quality he showed to us was the man has always been a silent listener. He will listen to you until you exhaust your point. And then when he has something to add, he will strike. And then we loved him for that. He never turned anybody away. Well, my wish for his 80th birthday is that the Nigeria he saw at the beginning, we hope and pray he lives to see the Nigeria of his wish, because the Nigeria of his wish is, I believe, is the Nigeria of the wish of all peace and progress loving people of this country. He has dedicated his life to serving this country from the time he met it. And we are happy he has made huge contributions, and we are happy he has lived to see his 80th year. And my prayer and wish is that we wish him many more useful, purposeful, and progressive years in life to come. Thank you.
Chief introduced himself to us. He wanted to be the president of Nigeria. We said, Chief, we have a work to do. And especially we up north, when at that time we don't even talk about discrimination, whether you are an Igbo, whether you are Yoruba, whether you are a Tiv, whether you are a Hausa. We just grabbed Chief Emmanuel, and he became part and parcel of the NRC. And we start campaigning for him in Nasarawa Plateau State then. And he seems to be a gentleman. As far as I'm concerned, he is, what I say, well-educated southerner with an intelligent of being a Nigerian. And I appreciate working with him, because one thing about him is when we say, Chief, let's do A, you say that is popular's decision. And I regarded him as an individual who deal personally with people and general public. And I enjoy working with him as a stalwart of NRC. I bid him a very happy years and many, many prosperous another 80 years. Allah ya bashi sa'a. Allah ya bashi lafiya. Allah ya ƙara mishi arziki. Abinda ya samu a baya, Allah ya bashi more than that. May God bless Chief. Allah kuma ya taimake mu. Thank you.
Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu, a fellow of Nigerian Society of Engineers, is our leader, an elder, an engineering icon. You know very well that he is a grandfather of this profession. We never actually indeed grew up to meet him practicing engineering. He is one of the early engineers we had in Nigeria who did everything to ensure the growth of the engineering profession in our country. He had a construction company as early as in those early days, maybe about 50 years back, known as Enic, and Hadel and Enic. And that company carried out a lot of construction projects across the country. And since then, Iwuanyanwu has been a father figure to us in the engineering profession. He loves engineering. I am surprised that he's not able to be here at this assembly. He always attends all our programs. And perhaps he's preparing for the celebration of his 80th birthday. That's why he's not here. So on behalf of the body of engineers in Nigeria, I'd like to congratulate our father. I'd like to congratulate himself and his family, and to wish him many more years of service for our fatherland.
Anybody who studied engineering in this country and practiced engineering, we all know who is Engineer Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu. And one, his passion for engineering, for the development of this country, for the development of young engineers. In fact, some of our past presidents of Nigerian Society of Engineers got their inspirations from him, like Engineer Eze, who first met him when he was undergraduate, and when he came in was even the way he entered the university to do an activity that made most of the students to like engineering. So even from his lifestyle, he exhibits engineering. Everything we talk about him is engineering. So we are very, very proud that we have him, and we are happy that he has reached the age of 80, and we pray God will give him more and more in healthy conditions.
Okay.
Sir, I wish God will preserve you, give you more wisdom, more peace in whatever you are doing, and continue to help us, guide us the way you have been guiding us. You don't miss words whenever you see something that we are doing wrong, you call us. So we pray God will, in his mercy, give you a lot of energy, because at this age, we know you are trying, but we want God to give you more energy, more wisdom, and healthy family.
Engineer Emmanuel Iwuanyanwu is a household name. If it is the Iwuanyanwu that we know, the one that floated the football club some years ago, the politician, the business mukuru, and a successful engineer, then I will say he is a great man. He is a man that has contributed in no small measure to the development of engineering in Nigeria, because he has employed many engineering personnel, and he has helped to grow new young engineers who have learned through him in his construction industry. Today, they are great consultants, successful engineering personnel. I wish him a very successful birthday. I wish him good health, long life, and I pray that the good Lord will continue to sustain him in his service to humanity and in his contribution to the engineering development in Nigeria. I wish him a very happy birthday.